Adobe XD is an all-in-one solution for designing, prototyping, collaborating, and sharing design concepts. That's a lot of functionality in one application, so let me give you a quick tour of the user interface. I'm here in Adobe XD working on my latest design. I began the design by coming here to the upper left-hand corner and clicking on the Home icon. Next up in the home screen, I can select the first artboard. I can always create a custom size here on the right-hand side. I'll come in and select the iPhone X. From there, XD opens up a new document and takes me to that first artboard. As I mentioned, I'm actively working on a design of my own, so let's go ahead and switch back over to that. To do so, I'll come to Window and then go back to that initial design. I can tell that XD has dropped me into design mode, which is one of three workspace layouts. I see it here in the upper left-hand corner, so I have design, prototype, and share. On the far left, I have a series of tools. So as I come in and start to design elements and click on them on the design canvas, I can use the pointer tool, for example. Towards the lower left-hand corner are a number of panels. The bottommost panel allows me to browse and select from hundreds of plugins out in the community to extend XD functionality. Above that, I have the Layers panel, and when I click on it, it's going to toggle open. As I click on objects on the design canvas, it will show me in a corresponding list on the left where I am in the Layers panel in that hierarchy. Also, as I click on objects on the canvas, the Properties Inspector here towards the right-hand side is going to show me properties that relate directly to the type of object I have selected. Back again here towards the lower left-hand side of the application, I can toggle between that Layers panel and an Assets panel. When I open up the Assets panel and scroll all the way towards the top, you can see I have the ability to extract colors that I'm using in the project. I can also extract character styles. And below that, I have a series of components. These components are elements that I'll reuse throughout my design. I can toggle between the list view and a grid view and just extend this out a bit to get a better look at all of those components that I do have available. At any time when I'm done working with those panels, I can always toggle them closed again by clicking on the icon one more time. Once I have my design all set and I'm ready to start to define my interactions, I can do that by clicking here in the upper left-hand corner on prototype mode. If I click on any object here on the canvas in prototype mode, and then, for example, click on a wire I might have defined, the Properties Inspector on the right-hand side is going to show me all of the interaction options I have available for any of the elements on the canvas. Once I have my workflow fully designed and I'm ready to share this experience with some of my stakeholders, I want to switch over to share mode. To do that, I'll come here to the upper left-hand corner once again and click on share. Here I can see which artboards on the design canvas will be included in the share prototype that I'm about to generate. And on the right-hand side, I can come in and set the type of share experience I'd like to have. Obviously, that is just a whirlwind tour of the user experience for Adobe XD. I encourage you to start to delve more deeply into the functionality of this pretty amazing application.